In the heart of the Downs on the south coast is the first of Britain's new universities to get into its stride, the new University of Sussex. The aim is to turn out full and cultivated citizens. This end is being achieved, not only by study, but by the interchange of ideas and experience.
There was so much going on in the 60s at that time that it's very hard to differentiate how much of it was a new university, how much of it was the clothes, how much of it was the music. But I think we were very aware that we were in the middle of something extraordinary, really.
Academically, Sussex University has been the pacemaker. The first of the new universities to open its doors to students, it can now boast 15 applications for every single place in its award-winning buildings.
We hope to produce students who will go out into the world of the future equipped with the kind of educational background that will enable them to adapt themselves to a world of change.
I thought I really wanted to be part of it, and I went down and had a look at the campus. And the university, of course, was pretty much still a building site.
We saw this building emerging from the soil. What we didn't notice was it was going to be an echo of Vespasian's Roman Colosseum. And then when we talked about the big spaces that were left, he said, fill them in imaginatively. And that very much echoed what we wanted to do at syllabus level. We wanted to experiment, we wanted to explore, we wanted to move into the future, but with a solid grounding.
We hope that they will not feel that their education has been completed at Sussex, that they become critical, knowledgeable, better informed.
Suddenly we were at university with every kind of different sort of person, and it was absolutely wonderful.
I wasn't particularly overly political, but I did get caught up in the fervour that swept through the campuses in 68.
Sussex prepared you to think quite outside the box, of thinking about a broad connectivity of subjects that may not at first sight have much to do with each other. And the area that I worked in, that I was recognised with the knighthood, is one of those kinds of areas where it crossed boundaries.
I very much like the idea of having closer contact with my tutors than you get in some of the other universities.
The relationship with the tutors was extraordinary.
You always felt very close to anybody else who was there, either as a tutor or as a student.
Something else that I think is very different about universities now is that people work so damn hard all the time.
I decided very early on that I wasn't that excited by going to lectures. For me, there was so much more going on in terms of, you know, making music and hearing music and being involved in that whole artistic community.
I, for example, got very much engaged in putting on concerts and dances. So people of a certain age who were at Sussex remember me as the man who put Hendrix on in the refectory.
I came out of it thinking I'm not as dumb as everybody thought I was when I was at school.
University of Sussex, its history and its attitude, I think, is something that really appealed to me. It's known for a left-field vision. It's been known for being able to think outside the box. And I think that makes Sussex pretty unique.